Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. You are all welcome to this epoch-making occasion, which is the eighth inaugural lecture of our dear university. We say welcome to all of you, good friends and family of the inaugural lecture. It is our pleasure to welcome you for sparing your time to felicitate with both the university and especially the inaugural lecturer. This is the eighth of its type, like I always said, which means that it is in the tradition of universities worldwide to have their professors who had attained that level to be inaugurated. So we say welcome to all of you, both the physical audience and those other people in the visual audience who were not able to be here physically, but nonetheless have joined us virtually. We believe that this event is being watched all over the world, and it gladdens our heart that we have in our midst members of the lecturer's family, as well as his friends and well wishers. We thank you as we await the entry of the academic procession, which is one of the important aspects of occasions of this nature. So in the interim, we welcome you. We request that you interact amongst yourselves to have better understanding of one another. Peradventure, this might be your very first time of meeting some of the people to your left or to your right or at your back. We do expect that at the end of this exercise, we would be richly blessed with the lecture that will be delivered today. Without any intention to preempt the topic of the inaugural lecture, I believe very deeply that you will have a second thought whenever you see any rock on your way after this lecture. Because by so doing, you will have a better understanding of the fortune that may be embedded in such rocks. Ladies and gentlemen, may I humbly request that you stand and please remain standing as the academic procession makes its entry into the inaugural lecture arena. Tradition of events of this nature that the academic procession is led by the university Miss Biara, followed by other very important personalities within the university, especially starting with the deans of our various colleges. The dean of the College of Business and Social Sciences, the dean of the College of Natural and Applied Sciences, the Dean of the College of Art and Communication Studies, as well as the Dean of the Postgraduate School, and the principal officers of the university. We have the librarian, the university bursar, the university registrar, the deputy vice chancellor, the inauguralist, the lecturer of today, for whom we are all here gathered, and the university vice chancellor. As the academic procession makes its way to the elevated seats, once again we have the university mess bearer, followed by the university registrar, followed by the Dean of Students Affairs, heavily followed by the Dean of the College of Arts and Communication Studies, and following immediately behind him is the Dean of the College of Business and Social Sciences, followed by the Dean of the Postgraduate School, and followed by the Dean of the College of Natural and Applied Sciences, who today is wearing a double cap as also the inaugural lecturer. He is immediately followed by another of the university in the person of the university bursar, followed by the university librarian, and then the university deputy vice chancellor and the university vice chancellor. Ladies and gentlemen, may I also humbly request that you remain standing as we open up this program by committing it to the hands of the Almighty God. As I invite the Dean of the College of Business and Social Sciences, Professor Abisori, to give us the opening prayer. Professor Abisori.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for this very glorious day that you have set aside for the purpose of our gathering today. We thank you, O Lord, because you have prepared your Son and you have taken him through thick and thin to be able to present himself to lead us through into opening our knowledge in another areas regarding his discoveries and his findings. As we are gathered, make this gathering profitable to all of us. Give your Son the utterance, the ability to deliver it to our understanding, and continue to bless him. Continue to make him a blessing. Bless our university as a body. Glory be to your holy name, O Lord, for we have prayed in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much for that wonderful prayer. Please remain standing. I indulge you, please, as we continue by singing the national anthem. The national anthem, please. Thank you. Please remain standing as we take the university anthem. Thank you very much. Please, you may have your seat as I invite the university registrar to continue with the rest of the proceeding. Thank you, the registrar.
Excellencies, the Vice Chancellor, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, other esteemed members of the University Management, the inaugural lecturer, Deans of Colleges and Dean of Student Affairs, eminent professors and other members of Senate of Kwafa University, esteemed members of the university community, captains of industries, our distinguished web audience, our dear and distinguished family members of the inaugural lecturer, gentlemen of the media, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I have the distinct pleasure and singular honor to welcome you all to this august occasion of the 8th in the series of inaugural lectures in the annals of Kwafa University. To God alone be the glory. I will now at this juncture very respectfully and humbly invite the Vice Chancellor, Professor Reuben G. Akolo, FFS, to declare the inaugural lecture open. Vice Chancellor, sir.
By the authority vested in me, I hereby declare the 8th inaugural lecture open.
Vice Chancellor, sir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the citation of the inaugural lecturer. I will therefore very humbly invite the Vice Chancellor, Professor Reuben G. Akolo, FFS, to present a citation on the inaugural lecturer, Professor Adewole John Adeola, and thereafter invite him to deliver his lecture. Vice Chancellor, sir.
The Deputy Vice Chancellor, vice chancellors of other universities, all their representatives, rectors and provosts of polytechnic and colleges of education, here present or their representatives, esteemed members of the Board of Trustees of Crawford University, members of the Governing Council of Crawford University, principal officers of the universities, members of staff, our respected virtual audience, great students of Crawford University, our distinguished guests of today, ladies and gentlemen, including ladies and gentlemen of the press, of the media. On behalf of the proprietor of Crawford University, Reverend Dr. Isaac Adigun, Board of Trustees and the Governing Council of Crawford University, I am most elated to welcome you all to this 8th inaugural lecture of Crawford University. The inaugural lecturer is Professor Adewole John Adeola of the Department of Geology and Mineral Sciences. Professor Adewole, please. Professor Adewole John was born in Erua Town, Oyo State, some few years ago. He attended Ebenezer Primary School, Erua, Oyo State, and then proceeded to St. Thomas Aquinas College, Akure, Ondo State, for his secondary education in 1979. Having passed his West African School Certificate examination brilliantly with distinction in 1984, he then proceeded to the then University of Ife, Ile Ife, now Obafemi Awolowo University, Ile Ife, OAU, where he bagged his BSc honors in geology in April 1989. He did his National Youth Service Corps Scheme, NYSC, between 1989 and 1990 in Ogun Oshun River Basin Development Authority, Alabata, Abeokuta, Ogun State. Professor Adeola was employed by NICO Engineering Limited, Ibadan, as a project geologist, stroke technical engineer, in January 1991. He rose to the post of the senior geotechnical engineer in that firm before he voluntarily resigned to establish his own company and was actively involved in geophysical exploration, ICT training of the staff of both federal and state civil service in Ekiti State. In his quest for knowledge, Professor A.J. Adeola proceeded to the Redeemed Christian Bible College, Lagos, where he bagged postgraduate diploma in theology and Masters of Arts in Pastoral Ministry, M.A. Pastoral Ministry in 2002 and 2014, respectively. So I'm safe to call him Pastor A.J. Adeola. Yet, Professor Adeola was not satisfied with all these academic achievements. He had to enroll for higher degrees of at the University of Ibadan, where he bagged his MSc in mineral exploration, specializing in economic geology and mining in 2006, and ultimately bagged his PhD in economic geology in 2014 from the same university. Professor Adeola is a registered member of the following professional association. He is a corporate member, Nigerian Mining and Geosciences Society, member, Nigeria Association of Hydrologists, member, registered member, Council of Nigerian Mining Engineers and Geosciences, COMEG, member, Nigeria Association for Engineering, Geology and the Environment, member, International Medical Geology Association, fellow, Institute of Oil and Gas Research and Hydrocarbon Studies, and so many others, which may be too many for me to mention here. Professor Adeola was the best graduating student in independent geologic mapping in 1988 in Geology Department OAU, Ile-Ife. He also won the highly prestigious 1992 Site Agent Award as the best staff of the year while at NICO Engineering Limited. He was a recipient of National Association of Petroleum Exploration grants in 2009. In addition, he was the Geologist of the Year 2012/2013 and 2019-2020 by Nigerian Mining Geology Society, Crawford University Student Chapter. Professor Adeola joined the services of Crawford University in 2007 as an assistant lecturer in the Department of Physical and Earth Sciences and rose through the ranks to the professorial position in the year 2020. Professor Adeola has served at various times in several capacities, among which are chairman and membership of several committees, acting dean, College of Natural and Applied Sciences, vice dean, College of Natural and Applied Sciences, head of Department of Physical and Earth Sciences, coordinator, Geology and Mineral Science Program. Currently, he is the dean, College of Natural and Applied Sciences of Crawford University, Igbesa, Ogun State. Professor Adeola has more than 40 publications, both in national and international journals, to his credit. Also, he has attended several conferences nationally and internationally. Professor Adeola John is happily married and blessed with children. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, join me as I invite Professor Adewole John Adeola to deliver the 8th inaugural lecture of Crawford University on the topic Nigeria Economic Fortune, Going Back to the Rock. Professor Adeola John, please, you have the floor.
The Vice Chancellor, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, the Registrar, the University Bursar, the ACSI University Librarian, the Dean of College of Business and Social Sciences, the Dean of College of Arts and Communication, the Dean of Students Affairs, all the directors present, professors in the house, members and representatives of the Council and Senate, heads of departments, other principal officers of the university, your Royal Highnesses and Majesties, my highly esteemed academic colleagues, non-academic colleagues, both administrative and technical session, our beloved and highly valued and articulate students, present and past, distinguished and highly esteemed guests, members of my nuclear and extended family, gentlemen of the media, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I give glory and honor to the Most High for this day, and I confess that today is a remarkable and highly cherished day in my life. To him be the glory and majesty for making my dream to come to pass, despite all odds and ends that have passed through the journey of my life. I am delivering this inaugural lecture almost 3 years after I became a professor of economic geology. It is a rare privilege. Words alone cannot express my profound and deep appreciation to everyone present here and those that are watching online celebrating with me today. The Vice Chancellor, sir, kindly permit me to sing this song before I proceed to the inaugural lecture to appreciate the Almighty God for his unique love and mercy upon my life. Just as David said in Psalm 118, verse 23, this is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our sight. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, my very soul shall shout hallelujah. Praise God for saving me. Mr. Chancellor, sir, I am very grateful for the opportunity given to me to deliver the 8th inaugural lecture of this university since inception. It is also the first to be given in your administration. Historically, this inaugural lecture is the first coming from my great Department of Physical and Earth Sciences, which means I'm the first to give inaugural lecture there. And the second coming from our College of Natural and Applied Sciences, Professor Bolaga Adegbolagute, my kinsman, my father, my brother, delivered the first inaugural lecture in this hall, titled Animal Skin. If you see it, you cannot unsee it. On the 14th of June, 2019. I'm most grateful to Professor Emmanuel Adodufayoshe, who helped me to pick the best topic, half of the 4 topics that I presented to him. You will all agree with me that this erudite professor or professors did excellently well when he was with us as the Dean of College of Natural and Applied Sciences and also as the Vice Chancellor of this as the Deputy Vice Chancellor of this university. An inaugural lecture is supposed to be presented in this manner to showcase the major research breakthrough of the lecturer. It's supposed to be presented in a manner that everybody in the audience will understand what the lecturer is saying. With that in mind, and because of that, I'll try as much as possible to make this lecture very interesting, informative, but not at the detriment of the technical details. The topic of this lecture was born out of my great concern about our nation that is presently experiencing what you can term as economic recession. I chose the topic, Nigeria's Economic Fortune, Going Back to the Rocks, based on my experience over the past 30 years that I've been taking geology students around the nation, teaching them, exposing them, this younger generation, exposing them to the hidden treasures that have been ignored and abandoned within the crystalline rocks and sedimentary terrains of Nigeria. Consequently, these economic viable resources have been ignorantly trampled upon by every day by everybody. We have been to several places in Nigeria during our trips, and I've shown them, they have seen so many mining sites, where mining activity was actually booming in those days. But what we have there today? We have abandoned, moribund mining equipment, dilapidated buildings that litter the entire area. And at the end of our field trips, our students used to return back to the campus with great burden in their hearts, thinking, with these numerous resources that we have, that God has blessed our nation with, why are we still living under below poverty line. Remember, if there is any nation that is blessed with numerous resources as we have it today, and not doing anything about it, will remain economically backward. The question that seems to agitate their mind, and still agitating our minds today, is what is the way forward? As a nation, we must not remain or continue wallowing in abject poverty, in the midst of abundant mineral resources that God has blessed our nation with. The beginning of my professional journey. When I was in secondary school, I used to be the best student in geography. Though I was a pure science student, I had an unusual interest in science subjects, and many people thought that I would become either a doctor or a pharmacist. But let me tell you, somebody like me, I don't even have interest, not out of interest, in medicine or pharmacy. My desire is to become an agricultural engineer because my father happened to be a peasant farmer that's always bending down like this whenever he was working in his farm. I thought by the time I become an agricultural engineer, I'll be practicing mechanized farming in my farm. Then I'll change the course of our family. But this idea, these dreams, was shattered by one of our family friends that visited us and asked me what I wanted to do. By the time I told him, he said, please don't do that. That if you study agricultural engineering, you are going to end up as a physics teacher. Because at that time, government was not even employing them. Ministries are not giving them financial assistance. And I don't want to become a physics teacher. I quickly dropped the idea. I knew nothing about geology while in secondary school. It was my beloved father, late Dr. Prince Adufos Adesegun Enrile, who was also my unusual friend, a great confidant, that introduced geology to me for the first time. He said, geology and petroleum engineering, they are more or less the same. And when I was about to fill my JAMB form, he said, why not fill geology and petroleum engineering? That was how I filled the course. I knew nothing about it. And he jokingly added that geologists and petroleum engineers, they work in oil company where they receive fantabulous, that's I quote him right now, fantabulous salary and mouth-watering allowances. I love money. I quickly changed my mind to study hydrology too. When I checked the meaning of geology in the dictionary, I discovered that geology is the study of rocks. And only science students can study the course because it involves application of sciences in studying and understanding the earth and the structure. To God be the glory. I was eventually admitted to University of Ife, now Bafemi Awolowo University, to study geology in 1984. Let me blow your mind. The first geology field trip that we went sparked up my love for the course because we were taken to places where they were actually extracting, mining, raw materials, resources, natural resources for the industries. And they were telling us that if you major in this area, you'll make a lot of money. This trip was led by Professor Rahman, an erudite professor, who eventually became my supervisor, and Professor and Dr. Oshan, who was my co-undergraduate supervisor. This erudite professor taught me how to be focused while working and while doing research. On many occasions, I would go to his office around 11 p.m., around 12 midnight, because in those days in the university, we walk around the town. Run the hours. No time, you will see students working. And by 11, Professor Rahman will come back to his office. I'll just go to his office to go and learn, to go and study. We became friends, and eventually he became my project supervisor. Not only that, he became my professional father, and to up to today, is my close confidant. Right from undergraduate days, geologic field exercise have been my hobby. And I love being in the bush, not hunting for animals at all. I'm not interested in bushmeat. I'm searching for the hidden treasures of the earth. I was the best student in independent geology map in 1986-87 academic session with an excellent grade. In 1989, I was invited by Professor Rahman to join an exploration team headed by Professor Yemi Oshin. Just a few weeks after my graduation, to explore for iron ore in Toto Muro Gadabuke in Plateau State. This team comprises of eminent geologists like Professor Rahman, Professor Anno of Blessed Memory, Professor Victor Olariwaju, Professor Bale, Dr. Oshan, and others that have forgotten their names. Let me tell you something. These eminent geologists actually exposed me and baptized me into the mineral exploration and economic geology. In fact, I was the youngest and the only fresh graduate in their midst. Since then, I have considered going to the field as something adventurous and also an exciting moment in my life. Then, what's an economic geology? An economic geology is a valuable tool for the nation's development. It's an important branch of geology that deals with different aspects of economic minerals. Minerals that can be extracted profitably, mark my word, profitably, and being utilized by mankind to meet our various needs. Let me put it in a simple way. Economic geology is a science subject that actually deals or focuses on earth materials that can be used for economic or industrial development. For the purpose of studying economic geology, we are interested in identifying the raw material for industries, the resources that are present in the rock, the ores that are there. We want to know the genesis, we want to know the history, we want to know the grade, and we want to know whether the quantity that we have there can be actually presented to industry for productivity. An economic geologist studies mineral deposits and possess leading information in this area. The first thing that economic geology will do is to evaluate what I'm dealing with. Is it going to be profitable at the end of the day when I start mining? There are several definitions of solid minerals, but for the purpose of this lecture, I will say that solid minerals are natural resources that form part of the earth's resources that beckon to human race for exploitation, inviting us. They are there. You cannot flash them, but we have to go and meet them. We are there, beckoning unto us, for us to come and develop, in order to develop ourselves and for our own usage. As these minerals are contained in the belly of the earth, on whose surface we dwell, and from whose surface we are extracting these minerals, our attitude must impact the physical environment in which and on which the operation occurring. Mr. Bachelor, sir, recently if you observe, we have increased emphasis that has come to be placed on the potential importance of the solid minerals. Everybody knows that solid minerals can now be added and can add value to our economy. And that is the subsector that everybody is going to now. The quest for diversification of the national economy, and in particular, the importance attached to breaking the dominance of crude oil in the export structure of the economy, has led to the focus on the solid mineral subsector. You all agree with me. For the past almost 5 decades now, we have depended and we are still depending on oil sector for our survival as a nation. I don't know what to say. And people are still imagining whether the discovery of 1956, the discovery of oil of 1966 is a curse or a blessing to our nation. Because whatsoever that happened to our hydrocarbon will surely happen, will surely affect other aspects of economy. You will agree with me that before the advent of oil, before the oil boom 1973, agriculture used to be our mainstay of income in this nation. In fact, agriculture used to contribute 60-70%, while oil used to contribute about 2.5% before 1973. But the inverse is the case today. Our nation has actually evolved from oil-producing country, we have become oil-relying nation. If you remove oil now, there's going to be a problem in Nigeria. Half of 6.3 trillion naira that was generated from exports in October, in the last quarter last year, crude oil alone contributed 35%. Crude oil alone contributed 35%. Can you just imagine? Why the mining sector contributed is 0.3%. Before, it used to be about 7% before the advent of oil, but presently, contributing less than 0.3%. And we have the resources there. I think it's high time we go back to the rock. The one sector that had the potential of attracting foreign exchange and to this country is the mining industry. ESPAC said that if we can harness our mineral resources, let me tell you, we are not going to remain where we are, and we need to wake up. As stated above, Nigeria is one of the developing nations that is very rich, very, very rich in minerals, and at the same time, one of the least developed nations due to overdependence on one sector, just one sector, as a major source of revenue. If anything happens to that major sector, we are finished. For rapid development, we need to move from mono-based approach and tap into each resources that are available in solid mineral development. Although, we used to make noise about it. If you have been listening to newspaper, if you have been listening to news, reading newspaper, we make noise about it. Oh, we are going to develop our solid sector. We make noise about it, but little action. I think that has to change. According to Data 2021, Nigeria is blessed with huge deposits of solid minerals distributed across the different geographical zones. As of today, we have over 44 different mineral resources that have been measured, the grade known, the extent known, the tonnage calculated, still waiting in the rock. What are we doing about it? What exactly are we doing? According to Obaje, 2009, Nigeria is endowed with many mineral resources, such as industrial minerals, gemstones, liquid energy fuels, that's petroleum, and other solid minerals, bitumen, coal, etc., as presented in Table 1. I could remember, a few years ago, Professor Fauci presented a paper here on the Nigeria bitumen prospects, almost about 8 years ago. Up to now, nothing has been done about it, especially about bitumen. Brethren, if you check that map very well, there is no state in this nation that is not blessed with one or two mineral deposits that are of economic importance, but presently being neglected, and we are not doing anything about it. This has to change. And you all agree with me that it must change. Let's quickly go through my professional journey. Let me quickly summarize my contributions in the field of economic geology. My research interests. I have interest in economic geological studies of weather profiles. I will tell you the reason why. I have great interest in economic studies of crystalline and other basement rocks in Nigeria. Exploration mining and groundwater exploration. I joined this university when this university was just barely 2 years old. And when I got to this place, I discovered that this university is located at the corridor of Agbara industrial area. We have industries all over this environment. What are we doing as a university? We need to contribute our quota so that they will know that we are here. Because of that, I took interest in studying the material, the raw material, the earth material that we have in this place. When I got to this place, there was a sump dug very close to our gates here, and I discovered that we had clay there. I took my student there, my first project student there. We collected samples. By the time we did the analysis, the chemical analysis, we took the samples to one of the paint industries that we have here. We discovered that By the time we used 100% of this material, the paint did not pass. 70 did not pass. By the time we used 25%, the paint produced was excellent. We now decided, okay, if we can have this material here, why are we importing? We need to look inward. We know we have a lot of mineral deposits here. Then let me ask you, or if you ask me, what are the mineral deposits? They are naturally occurring concentration of metals or minerals that can have economic value. Before you can call something a mineral deposit, a resource, must have economic value. They are formed through several geologic processes, which I'm not going to label you with. Magmatic processes, supergene and enrichment, sublimation, residual and mechanical concentration, hydrothermal processes, metamorphism, etc., sedimentation. All these processes that we teach our students, we have a lot of deposits forming and accumulating inside them. The weather product, when you have a rock, and that's why we talk in millions when you are in geology, the weather product from rocks, we have a lot of treasures, a lot of valuable minerals, a lot of deposits that are beckoning to us to come and harvest them inside them. So I discovered that in Nigeria, we have the bedrock, which comprises of, in most cases, the fresh rock. And after this fresh rock, when you look a little bit further, you will see partly weathered. We call it saprolite. Then you have the soil profile. And the first soil profile starts from the clay. After clay, you get to the laterite. After laterite, you get to the top soil. The clay and the laterites, they are the common industrial minerals formed from the weathering of rocks that we are talking about. And nearly everywhere, we find this clay and laterite. But what are you doing about it? Other nations are making millions out of it, but we are not doing anything about it. In order not to waste our time, let me quickly summarize my activities in this nation. So far, so good. We have worked on clays and laterites, especially on soil profiles in Ondo State, Ekiti State, Oyo State, Kogi State. Let me just summarize. Adegbe and Adeola 2015, Oyebola and Adeola 2016. We studied the mineralogy and the physical chemical properties of several clay deposits derived from weathering of rocks in Ondo and Ekiti State, southwestern Nigeria. We went as far as Odiaye, Akure, Ishuakoko, Ayadi, Ore, Idoile, Ikerekiti, Ipole. All these locations, they are in Ondo State and Ekiti State. We discovered that we have so many clays that have not been touched, that have not been reported in the literature, and we worked on them. What did we observe? We discovered that based on their mineralogical and chemical compositions and physical characteristics, the clay deposits meet the industrial specifications for the production of ceramics, refractories, paving bricks, paints, and pharmaceutical products. In this area where we have many companies that are dealing with pharmaceutical products, producing pharmaceutical materials in this place. 2017, Adeola Atubonemu, I work with this guy. I work on residual soil above basement rocks around Ore. Ore is where we are going towards Benin. We are looking for all enrichments in this environment. If there's going to be any accumulation in this area. And we discover that from our chemical analysis, that there are some components that are being leached out of the system. Something like sodium oxide, magnesium oxide, calcium oxide are being leached out of the system. And at the same time, we have accumulation of other matter like iron is getting increased in the system, and iron is getting titanium oxide. When iron is increasing like that, it will form what we call laterite. But if it's not iron, that if it's aluminium, it will form what we call bauxite. Then after that, from we look at the basement rocks, and we discover that the silicate mineral that are in the parent rocks actually weathered to form the clays that we are talking about. Then what's happened to be our conclusion? When we finish our work, we discover that this clay is very, very useful for the production of ceramics, for the production of tiles, for the production of construction material, and bond bricks. But we are actually looking for, and we are importing tiles every now and then. But we thank God because today we have industry springing up around this area producing tiles. In Oyo State, we did a lot of work in Oyo State. 2015, I was at Ejianure searching for clays, and I eventually discovered that we have a lot of clay deposits, though I've not actually estimated accurately the deposit that we have in that place. We have a lot of clay in the Ejianure, very close to Ibadan. And the following year, 2016, we went back again to go and study the profile, the mineralogy and the geochemistry of the profile from the top to the base. And not only that, I am from Erua. Charity begins at where? At home. We took our journey down to Erua to go and explore for clays and laterite in that place. And I discovered that even in Erua, where I come from, we have deposits of Erua clay and laterite very close to Akolu, very close to Akpangpa. That was why you saw our deposit there. I was able to analyze. I compare the clay from Erua, the clay from Maya, the clay from Igbora. That's my constituency. With what is happening, with what we have in China, with what we have in Greece and Berlin. And I discovered that our clay, in that the clay from that area, can comfortably compete with this clay for the production of redstone ware. We have all this in there, and our children are still looking for job. That is not good enough. That is not good enough. Let's come to Ogun State. I've been in Ogun State now for almost 17 years, working tirelessly and comparing, searching for economic minerals. We have done a lot of work around our in the Ijebu area, Oru and Ijebu Igbo. We spent days collecting samples, analyzing samples, chemically looking at their mineralogy, and at the same time trying to make recommendations to the industry. And we discovered that these clay are also very good for industry. Having left the basement there, we came towards Papalanto. If you came from Sangwater here, we went to Papalanto, we went to Ifo, then went to Imoto. Imoto, that is where Dangote is actually working today. We actually examined the clay deposit there. Even at Imoto, the entire village is on clay, and that clay is a unique type. Very, very unique, very, very rich in carbonates. But what are we doing about it? The investigation carried out over there was just to evaluate their mineralogical composition, their physical parameters, in order to determine their industrial applications. And we are able to conclude that the clay derived from this area is also good, provided we are ready to do something. Not only that, recently, about 2 years ago, 2020, we were at Ijesha Ijebu, very close to Agowo here. We saw something unusual in that place. We saw clay from sedimentary environment, clay from metamorphic environment, and clay from igneous. So these three clays, we started studying their chemistry, their mineralogy, their physical properties, and were able to come out with something very unique. I did not stop there. We went as far as going to Kogi State with Professor Bolaniwa, 2006. Thank God that he's here seated. I'm going to say something about him very soon. We went there with Reg. We were going from one village to another, from Okolom to Iye, from Iye. We're just going like that. And we discovered that we have a lot of talc deposits in that place. If we are to check our ladies, our mamas, bags as we are seated here, I'm very sure that we are going to see powder in our pockets here. The powder that you have there happen to be products of produced from talc. And do you believe it? Nigeria, we are still importing powder when we have fresh, very neat. That is my car in those days, parked on weathered talc. And later when we moved towards EA, towards Oklahoma, we now saw fresh, very whitish, that can be used for the production of paints, paper, can be used in pharmaceutical industry, for food processing, for production of ties, and also for so many things. But what are we doing about it? We are not. We are just looking, waiting for manna to fall from heaven. In search of ores and industrial minerals in the north central Nigeria, I did not limit activities to southwestern Nigeria. We went as far as going to north central part of Nigeria to go and search for all industrial minerals. Thank God, I went together with Professor Bolaniwa, is here seated. Thank you for honoring us today with your presence. If you know Panshi and you go there and you come back, you will do special thanksgiving. But this man, this great man, great geologist, great professor, did not mind. He was seriously sick. He said, Adeola, let us go there. He was on look on a boost when we were working on the field. Just because we have the interest of this nation. Because in that place, we have a lot of deposits in that place, not yet recorded in any literature. I wanted to break a new ground. What did you see? We are looking for metallic ores, which are often found in the profiles. We are looking for all these things. And we discovered that we have different types of rocks here that have these profiles. We have about 7 rocks in that environment. What are the rocks? We have cyanite, yoga granite, basalt granite, granite gneiss, other basalt, newer basalt, and laterite basalt. Nobody ever worked in this area. In fact, we could not even lay our hands on any literature. Looking for what? And we covered 4 major towns: Bokos, Kubu, Payam, and Panshin. If you have to go to Panshin, you need minimum of 2 cardigan, because that place is the coldest place in Nigeria. So our findings is what we are now looking at on the screen. At the end of the day, by the time we did our evaluation, based on our chemical compositions, mineralogical composition, textural classification, density, grain size distribution, plasticity test, modability test, firing properties, we look at the color, linear shrinkage, water absorption. We did so many things in order to classify, in order to know what we can use this material for. And we discovered the following. Please just listen attentively. Out of the 7 profiles, major profiles that we have in Panshin area, only 2 were not good for the construction of roads. 2, the profile above granite gneiss is not lateritic. Although when you look at it, it's a little bit looking like laterite. But by the time we look at it and we did our calculations, after our chemical analysis, we discovered that this profile is what we call non-lateritic, because we have something that we normally use. We call it silica secure side. By the time you calculate it, once it is more than 2, that is not good for road construction. And also, the one on cyanide, the profile on cyanide, is also that is a non-lateritic soil. But on basalt granite, on younger granite, older basalt, lateritized basalt, newer basalt, all of them, they are lateritic soil that can be used, be employed by engineers for construction to be used as base material based on our laboratory analysis in that environment. And we concluded that the materials in this area can be used for the construction of roads, because we have vast deposit of laterites in that place. Can you see on the screen? Vast. We don't have this kind of laterite deposit in this southwest. But you go to that place, although the environment is not friendly, but presently they are also using it now. And not only that, the laterite and the clay, they are minerals that must be used when producing cement. We have Dangote moving to Ogun State. We're supposed to ask ourselves, why is Dangote coming to Ogun State? After all, we have Lafarge here producing cement. We have this material here, but what are we doing about it? So we discovered that the clay in that environment is very good and can be used as a component of cement for cement production. What about when it's coming to production of paste? Just like the one that we saw in Crawford. It's very close to Crawford here. We discovered that the clay derived from older basalts is very rich in multimorunite. And multimorunite is a swelling clay. See, that clay has absorbing property. It can absorb water, dyes, grease, and because of that, it is preferred in paint industry. So we recommended that whosoever that needs this material for product of paint should go to that place. Not only that, we discover that the laterite in that place is not good for production of the clay, and the laterite in that place is not good for the production of fertilizer, because it has high iron content. It's even more than 5%. And once it's more than 5%, it is not good. The same thing, that the clay that we had there is also good for production of paper. Let's move a little bit before I round up. When we got to this place, this environment, we have peasant farmers. The main occupation that we have in this environment has happened to be farming. In fact, from here now, you move towards Alagogo and towards Adodo. You will see government settlements there. So government farms are there. What do they need? They need water. And surface water is not enough. They have been drilling boreholes, they have been collecting water, and they discovered that at times they run into difficulties. And because of that, I decided, let us do something in this environment. And if you came through Sango, from Sango, we started working on underground water. We wanted to determine the physicochemical parameters of the underground water from Sango to Aton to Lusada. We went as far as Totowu, Igbesa. We came back again from here now to Alagogo. We did a lot of work towards Alagogo to Adodo, from Adodo to Iloro. From Iloro, we went to Owode. From Owode, we went to Ilaro. We have robust information about the groundwater in this environment. That's what we have been doing over the years. And we discovered the following. That in this place, the water in this environment is slightly acidic. The pH of the water in this environment is between 4 and 5.5. And according to WHO, the recommendation given to us, the pH is supposed to be between 6.5 and 8.5. But nothing to write, it's just slightly acidic. We can still drink it. So we should not worry ourselves about it. Not only that, we discovered that the underground water that we have in this place is very, very low in what we call metal concentrations. Very, very low. And we have not actually discovered metal that can cause cancer has not been discovered. So we thank God. We are able to recommend to the people in this environment that the water in this place is also safe. By the time we analyze geochemically, by the time we analyze all the samples collected from Sango to this place, to Lusada, from Lusada down to Ilaro, we are able to discover by subjecting all the data that we have to what we call irrigational indices, we discover that the magnesium adsorption ratio, Kelly ratio, permeability index, and the residual bicarbonate, all of them, they were within the range, good for irrigation. So we recommended to this environment that is very, the water, underground water that we have in this place is very good for irrigation. We were not yet satisfied. We went as far as going geophysical, using vertical electrical sanding to determine what we call geoelectric layer in this place, to be able to tell the indigenes the kind of profile that we have in this place using geophysical method. And using that method, we are able to pinpoint and we are able to locate where they're supposed to drill their boreholes instead of doing trial and error. And at the end of the day, they fail. Where they can get fresh aquifer, fresh water. So we are able to recommend to the people in this environment. And not only that, we have actually documented this, and we are waiting for the government to patronize us so that we can give the remaining information to them. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, we have observation when it's coming to geology. We discover that the enrollment in geology is actually nosediving. Parents are no longer interested in sending their students to go and study geology because they heard that oil industry is crashing. That is an erroneous belief. Geology is a very wide area. We have so many courses in geology. For example, as I'm standing before you, I've never worked in oil industry. I'm an economic geologist. We have geotechnical engineers, they're also geologists. We have geology working in Ministry of Commerce and Industry. We have geology working in geological survey. We have geology working in space. We have geology working everywhere because there is nowhere in the world There are stuff that I want to do that's not going to be related to geology one way or the other. I want to advise you. Send your student, send your work to study geology. You will never regret it. But we have a challenge in this nation. It's a serious challenge. And I want to quickly mention it. Insecurity and protection. All of you, we know. I don't need to overflog you. We have problem of insecurity. Our students can no longer go to the field as they used to, as we used to do in those days. We just enter, take a traverse inside bush, and begin to do our exploration. But nowadays, the fear of Boko Haram, the fear of kidnapping, is the beginning of wisdom. 2014, we were on our trip to North, because once we start our trip from Crawford University here, we'll go as far. We'll go from here to Ibadan, from Ibadan to Elisha, Elisha to Ondo State, to Akure, Akure to Owo, from Owo. We just go to Kogi, from Kogi, we get ourselves to Lokoja, from Lokoja, we move towards Lokoja, from Lokoja, we bust at Abuja, and from Abuja now, we move towards North. At the time we used to go to Mina, from Mina we go to Bauchi, but because of insecurity, we cannot go and show our students what we have as a nation. When you get to Enugu, we have a lot of deposits. Come Enugu, wasting, and nobody is doing anything about it. But insecurity is turning geology to become a classroom course, just like mathematics, because parents are also afraid. But thank God, Crawford University, we are doing our best. We just came back from field. I want to say thank you to Pro Chancellor for his support over the years. I will not end this one before I go to acknowledgements without saying this. When we are talking about going back to rocks, our nation needs to go back to rocks. Our nation needs to go back to rocks. As individuals, we need to go back to rocks. I just want to say this one. The Bible says, Jesus is the only foundation that we have. Psalm 11 verse 3. If the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? The foundation of Nigeria has been destroyed. But the righteous can do so many things. The righteous can do so many things. We need to change our attitude as a nation. We talk, but we don't do it. And we need to change from that aspect. As human beings, when we say yes, let our yes be yes and our no be no. What I observe that is happening in this nation is that people in government, they are just interested in what they can grab. And as some of us are also hoping to join them come May 29. But what are you going to do with all this thing? Jesus is the only solid rock that can make our nation prosper. Let me round up this lecture by acknowledging some people. You agree with me that a tree cannot make a forest. Over the years, so many people have been there for me. God raised them up, and today I want to celebrate them. I give glory to the Almighty God for his love and care, for his divine guidance right from the beginning of my life. He is always there for me. Whatsoever that I am today is by his special grace, and I'll forever remain grateful unto him. He brought me from a miry clay and set my feet on solid ground. I want to say hallelujah. I am short of what to express my deep appreciation to the Vice Chancellor, Professor Ruben Dia-Kolo, for giving me this opportunity to present this inaugural lecture. To be honest, I was not expecting it now. I want to use this occasion to thank him and the entire management for making my dream come true. My gratitude goes to Professor M.A. Ige, the pioneer vice chancellor of this university, who actually gave me employment, first employment into the university, And this actually exposed me to what we call university culture. And I want to appreciate Professor S.A. Anyolaja for giving me, for standing with responsibilities. At times, I would discover that, I would tell him that, sir, I would not be able to do this thing. But this VC will say, my great geologist, we can do it. And at the end of the day, God used to help me. I want to appreciate him today for bringing the best out of me. I especially acknowledge with deep appreciation Our Eastern Vice Chancellor, Professor Isaac Rotimi Ajayi, he is not only my boss, but my coach, my confidant, my mentor, a special friend. My academic program is being monitored by this great professor. Every now and then, I can boldly say it anywhere that he is my boss, but at the same time, he's a special brother to me from another mother. Prof, I appreciate you greatly for what God has done for me through you in getting to where I am today. On many occasions, this professor, this vice chancellor, gave me the opportunity to represent him outside this university as vice chancellor, not as representative, as vice chancellor, with all the privileges attached. I want to say thank you. In fact, I've been grafted into his family. I want to say special kudos to his wife and her mother. In fact, they are on their way to this place. They are just leaving the barrier now. They're on their way to this place. I'm using this occasion to specially thank the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Alaba Simpson, who also doubled as the chairperson, University Ceremonial Committee. I was scared when she informed me that it was my turn to give the 8th inaugural lecture of this university. I was seriously scared. She encouraged me to start putting my lecture material together. She even said, don't worry, if need be, call on me. I'm ready to assist. Let me tell you, that word alone did the magic. If not, this occasion will not come up now. In fact, she is a mother indeed, with unique love and care. My sincere appreciation goes to my MSc and PhD supervisor, Professor Anthony Temidayo Bolaniwa. Can you please stand up for recognition? He has been following me since 2004. Not only him alone and his wife. Please, mommy, stand up. They have been around since yesterday. I really appreciate you. Thank you very much. He is more than a supervisor. Please have your seat. He is not more than a supervisor to me. He is, as you are looking at him, he is my mentor. He is my friend. He is my confidant. There was a time I wanted to leave this university. None of you are not aware, including the staff here. I told him, he said, don't go anywhere. Stay there. And I'm here. I'm not regretting it. I am very grateful for your patience and for your assistance every now and then. My special thanks also go to his wife, Dr. Mrs. A.O. Bolaniwa. Very soon, I'll be your inaugural lecture for your special prayer. Not only that, is a mouth-watering delicacies and a warm reception. In fact, my children normally ask me, when are you going to Daddy Bolaniwa's house? Just because of coolers. Because nobody carry coolers from their house. And something is unique about the family. We are welcome at any time. Either 12 midnight, 11 a.m., we are welcome. And the mother of my supervisor became my mother. The prayer of his mother and the prayer of his in-law, they normally pray for me as if they gave birth to me. Apart from giving me food, and that prayer is still working in my life. Mama is a blessed memory. But don't worry, Ma, your mommy will still stay alive for long. I want to especially appreciate Professor Fayoshi, not only for showing special interest in my academic progress, but also in the welfare of my family. Baba Fayoshi is a father in a million. My wife and I are now Baba Fayoshi's children. Not only that, Baba Fayoshi has adopted my first son as his own grandchild now, because he supervised his BSc Geology program. My special appreciation goes to Professor M.A. Rahman, my undergraduate supervisor. This man gave me good career foundation in geology, and equally taught me how to be rugged on the field with analytical mind. I really appreciate you. I appreciate Professor T.R. Ajayi for providing material when we were looking for material to start the PhD work. He was the only person that actually gave us something. I really appreciate Professor T.R. Ajayi. I want to appreciate Professor Silas. I know he's on. He's in the U.S. and he said he will watch us this afternoon. On many occasions, this professor will join us on the field, teaching geology students on the field free of charge for this, I think he deserves an applause. He taught me selfless service. And my exposure to other universities happens to be through Professor Silas Dada. I appreciate you, sir. I want to appreciate. It's a great privilege to be accepted as one of the academicians of Professor Idowu Olayinka. I know that you are watching me right now, because as at 3:30 this morning, he was still discussing with me. He said he will watch me online. So I really appreciate you, sir. I want to appreciate you dearly, because you are ever willing to pull me up the ladder of success in my career. I acknowledge Professor G.O. Adeyemi, a.k.a. Helper of Destiny, with a deep sense of appreciation, because he was instrumental to my admission, to my MSc admission. Well, I was not admitted. I was not given the admission. I was so happy. I'm still coming to that one. I was so happy because I didn't want to go back to school. But he gave a call to Professor Bolaniwa. He never knew that to become my supervisor. And later on, the two of them put us together. They admitted me. And the product is the one standing before you today. Not only that, he's a special friend to Professor Adeyemi. He's a special friend to my wife. I appreciate Professor Okunola, a vibrant and regular professor of geology, in his, for his numerous academic and professional support. I want to appreciate Professor Enyola, who always saying to me, don't worry, Adeola, work, even in the midst of opposition. Work, and you are going to reap it. I appreciate Professor Djani, Professor Inton, and Professor Boboye, Professor Ladimeji, Professor Dukoya, Professor Yedele, Professor Badebo. Happened to be the first person that taught me how to write paper. He came here, and we sat down together, and he initiated me into paper journal writing. I want to appreciate him for that. The list is so endless. But I want to appreciate a set of people. Though they have got to be with our Lord, but they actually contributed a lot to my academic career. One of them, these people are Professor A.F. Abimbola, Professor Olusegun Kainde Philip, Dr. Akai Gobi, Professor Edwards, Professor Eluese, and Mr. Adebuyi. May their soul rest in peace. I want to appreciate Professor Adekoya and Professor Olade. They were, one time or the other, they were here impacting and also teaching me. I appreciate you dearly. I want to appreciate all the staff of Crawford University. Time will not permit me. I have their names in the booklet. I appreciate you. Starting from Professor Bella Gute, Professor Ludotu, all the things. I appreciate all of you, including the CONAS management, wonderful management team, Dr. Adefokun, Dr. Faboyede, Dr. Badi Daniel, Dr. Ebel Sifo, Tristan Okonufwa, Dr. Akijobi. These people are wonderful. They are the ones making this happen in that college. I appreciate my professional colleagues, Dr. Isibo, the pioneer geology lecturer, aka my boss. Thank you very much. Colonel Dare Fagoyinbo, you are appreciated. It is Dairo, Mr. Latuji, Rene Loluwa, Folashade, Akinyele, I appreciate all of you. I want to appreciate Mr. Muyadeyemi and his wife, Adebukola, and his children, Jedidaya and Jacob, for being graciously knitted into my family in law. You are more than a brother to me. You are part of today's success story. All the brethren, the pastors from the Redeemed Christian Church of God, I appreciate you all. I appreciate Professor Pastor E. Adeboye and his wife, from whom I'm receiving spiritual nourishment every now and then. Thank you very much. The lists are there, and I'm very sure that when I get to your copy, you'll be able to go through the list. I shall be forever be grateful to my grandma, Deaconess Joanna Adejoju Atoda. That is my mama, aka Grandma Ibadan. Before you clap, listen to me very well. For your unflinching support to give me better education. After my primary education, I could not further my education again due to financial constraints. She kept on asking me, they were labor dad to go, what do you want to do for life? And my constant answer is, Mofekawe, I want to study. I want to further my education. Despite the fact that I failed 3 times, this great mama was undaunted. And she put my feet back to the class. Without the knowledge of my parents, my biological fathers, please, ma, can I please be on your feet? She is more than 80 years today. If not because I'm going to break protocol, I will come to you and prostrate in that place. I want to appreciate all my siblings. Deremi, wonderful, is here. Demola is here. Poradika and Okudele, they are there. Natoka is watching online. They are, in fact, all of you, you are just too wonderful. They are also there every now and then to see me at the top. I'm delighted to recognize and appreciate my mommy. You know, I have many mommies. Dickness Adeyoyinile. Presently, she's watching this program. Finally, call Grandma Akure for all your sacrifices to see me through my secondary and tertiary education. Half of your meagre salary as a secondary teacher, you single-handedly sponsor my secondary education and my first degree program in geology. Ah, you are wonderful. You even went, I know where you went ahead to go and borrow money from your friends just to make you comfortable on the campus. You are indeed a virtuous woman, and you forever remain evergreen in my memory. I am delighted and indeed grateful to Mr. and Mr. Luenile for their dependable love and care. Thank you very much for being there for me. I just want to say a big thank you to my biological parents, Most Senior Apostle Julius Tobola Adiola, of blessed memory, and my mama, Madam Alice Ogukemi Adiola, for their prayers and support. My mother could not be here, my biological mother could not be here today because she's more than 100 years old now. But I'm very sure that she's actually participating in one way or the other. To my in-law, I want to say thank you very much. My mother-in-law just wants to see me at the top of my career, and God has actually answered her prayer. I'm a beneficiary of Pastor and Mrs. Kayode's Ajao's prayer. Tope, you appreciate it. I want to appreciate the only part that remains for me as my father, and that is Deacon, Daddy, and Mommy Abulukwe Adiola. Can you please stand up for recognition? That is my father. Please, a round of applause. Your contribution to my source cannot be quantified. You are always there to support me through thick and thin. Your fatherly advice and support kept me on the track of greatness up to today. And Professor Biodun Adiola, we got admission to IFE together. We sat down together the same day. We matriculated the same day. And today, the two of us are professors. Shall we just thank the Almighty God? Biodun, shall we see you? Special thanks to Mr. Adedimeji Tope Adegbenju and his wife. Blessing for your dependable support and encouragement. This can never be quantified. You are always there to go all out, even when it's not even convenient, for just to see my family happy. I am proud of you. Adedimeji, always I'm proud of you. Finally, listen, everybody. I want to specially thank my better half. My special friend. My counselor. My guest. A virtuous woman. Mon amour. Assistant controller general. Peter Obadu. Please stand up. Someone like me, after my first degree, I made up my mind never to go to school again. Because the way we were battered at the University of Ife, I vowed never to step any classroom in my life. But this wonderful woman that God gave unto me kept on pushing me. Literally, she got admission form for me. She at the University of Ife at Ibadan, as if I was a baby. In fact, when Dr. Adeyemi was asking, who is called for this program? I never said a word. Thank you for pushing me into this kingdom. Do you know something? She sacrificed a lot. When she knew that we could not even afford it, she made herself available to make sure that I should go back to school. And her desire is to be called Yahoo Professor. I've never had. And God has answered your prayer. Your dream has finally come to pass. She is also on her PhD. I want to see your professor, who is also a professor very soon. Danny, you are simply wonderful. Great. You are one out of a million. Thanks for always being there. For filing in several times. I'll be in the sitting room, reading one thing or the other. She will be there praying for me. In fact, she had to leave Abuja. She left Abuja on Monday. She came back on Tuesday just because of this program. Darling, don't worry. You are going to live forever. I want to appreciate my children who are not here this morning, but they are watching us. God has given me wonderful children. And I want to mention their name. Ebukoluwa is also a geologist. My wife is also a geologist. I'm also a geologist. And we are just like that in our family. And Erioluwa, he is a computer guru. Samuel Adebejo could not come because he's writing an exam. He's an electrical engineer. Dr. Samuel Amatade is she's our daughter, who is also a microbiologist. And Blessing Amatade, a mathematician. Can't you say that I'm blessed with wonderful children? I want to appreciate you for your patience, your endurance, and your understanding. They are always ready to make daddy happy. I'm so proud of you, my children. Finally, my sincere appreciation goes to the Almighty God, my creator and helper. I confess with all my heart, this is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in my sight. You are the rock of ages, and I'm hiding in you. Thank you for listening.
Let's be seated. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, you will agree with me that a professor of geology has just spoken. It is now my honor and privilege to formally receive Professor Adewole John Adeola into the prestigious and elite league of inaugurated professors. I urge you not to rest on your ass, but to continue to provide sound and excellent academic leadership and mentorship to younger and upcoming academics. Congratulations.
I wish to present my inaugural lecture to Professor Ruben Diakono, the Vice Chancellor of this great institution, Crawford University.
Another round of applause for that very great lecture. I suppose that Professor Adewole John Adeola deserves a better round of applause. Epatewo.
We appreciate you, sir. Vice Chancellor, sir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, we are gradually winding down And at this juncture, I will respectfully and very humbly invite the Vice Chancellor, Professor Ruben G. Akolo, FFS, to take the closing remarks. Vice Chancellor, this is sir.
My closing remarks supposed to be recognition and appreciation of dignitaries and guests that were here. And you will agree with me that the presenter have done my work very well. I wouldn't have been able to do better than what he has done in recognizing people, eminent people that are here present to grace this occasion. I just want to mention, recognize a few people in area where he might not have touched. And the inaugural lecture book, everything about appreciation, acknowledgement is contained there. My in-laws always say, address Opojuleta law. So you can get a copy of the inaugural lecture and you find all appreciation. He has mentioned almost everybody there. But I want to recognize the scholars, our scholars. That is also will take over from us that are here tomorrow. That is the scholars. They are here present. Please stand up for recognition. Yes. These are the high flyer academics that are coming up, that as we fade away from this high table or in academics, they will take over from us. You are welcome. You are recognized. You are beginning to see how it is done. You will do this also. Yes, the lecturer, he has talked how we can cut rock and get money. And for almost 1 month, I think he just rushed back to come and present this lecture to tell us how to cut rock. He has been the rock. I will call him. He said, you can see me in Ekiti Hill. We are here. But he now rushed back to come and present this lecture. We appreciate you. I also want to recognize our web audience, that is virtual audience, for following along with us on this eighth inaugural lecture. And I want to recognize some other people again. The supervisor of our professor, I want to appreciate you for the great work done. And also the wife to the supervisor. You are well done. Yes, now I want the whole family, the Adeolas that are present, I want them to stand up for recognition. Thank you very much. You are welcome. Most of the children, they are watching virtually because they are also into rock cutting. You are welcome. You can sit down. And he has glossed over, but if you look at the lecture book, you know about the wife of the inaugural lecturer. That is Assistant Cultural General of Custom, Mrs. Adeola. Thank you for the good job. Well done. We appreciate you. We also have representative of the Vice Chancellor of Covenant University here present in the person of Professor Aneke, Dean of College of Science and Technology. You are welcome. Thank you. We have Professor Abiodun Adeola, Aderemi Atanda from the presidency. Please greet Mr. Presidency for us that the cashless economy is still biting here. You are welcome. Pastor and Mrs. Kayode Ajao and his assistant provincial pastor. Also, Barrister Oladimeji, Barrister Tokpe Esize, Mama Okumbajo, Engineer Sukomi Dele, Deacon Adeola standing in for the father. Yes, we have known you, we have recognized you. Thank you very much. We have Deaconess Adeyoye Atanda, Mr. Samson Adejare Adeola, Pastor Mrs. Omotade, Pastor Mrs. Oreoluwa Olorunsola, Dr. Tunde Olagunju, members of RCCG, Rose of Shalom, you are welcome. We appreciate you all. Thank you for standing by your pastor. Yes. Also, I want to appreciate our able Nigerian customs service men that accompany the wife of our presenter here. You are recognized. You are welcome. I thank you all. I want to appreciate the principal officers here present, the deans, dean of PG school, dean of colleges, dean of students. I also want to appreciate the professors in the house, heads of departments, heads of units, entire staff of Crawford University, our world-class students. I want to appreciate you all, and you are recognized. You are welcome. For our special guests invited by the presenter of today, we have just a light refreshment for you somewhere around that site, and the Senate members are also invited.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, we crave your indulgence to take just a few announcements. I first and foremost give God the glory for the privilege and the great success recorded at this eighth inaugural lecture, Nigeria Economic Fortune, Going Back to the Rocks, by no other personality than the eminent Professor of Geology, Professor Adewale John Adeola. We appreciate you once again, sir. And I also join my voice to the with the Vice Chancellors to appreciate our distinguished guests who have actually squeezed out time from your very busy schedule to be here. We appreciate both also our online and virtual audience for your patience and your rapt attention. May God bless you real good. Permit me to stress that admission is still ongoing, Crawford University, particularly into the Geology and Mineral Sciences program. As earlier announced by Professor Adeola, the inaugural lecturer, as well as all the other 18 programs in the university. At the end of the program, just like the Vice Chancellor has actually rightly said, the invited guests, members of management, deans of colleges, dean of student affairs, are to proceed to the mass communication annex for their refreshments. Others in the audience will proceed to their colleges to have their refreshments also. We also want to appreciate our very profound and deep appreciation to the chairperson and esteemed members of the ceremonials committee for, you know, packaging this program, this 8th inaugural lecture, and making it a huge success. We appreciate you, Chairperson Ma. At the end of the program, the academic procession will leave the hall in reverse order. And at this juncture, we will crave indulgence to rise and remain standing while the procession will leave the hall in the reverse order. At this juncture, ladies and gentlemen, I will very humbly and respectfully invite the Vice Chancellor, Professor Reuben J. Akolo, to close the 8th inaugural lecture. Vice Chancellor, sir.
I declare the 8th inaugural lecture closed.
Thank you very much, our dear Vice Chancellor. You all recall that when we wanted to start this program, we did commit it into the hands of the Almighty God. And at this juncture, may I request that we rise as we as well commit the closing of this program to the hands of Almighty God, as I invite the incumbent director of the Quality Assurance and Training Unit, our own very eminent Professor Onowa Yaloku, to give us the closing prayer. Professor.
Our most loving Father, we thank you in Jesus' name. We give you the glory and honor for making this 8th inaugural lecture a great success. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. We thank you because this lecture could not have been possible without your own benevolent presence and assistance. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. We thank you for the very topic, Nigeria economic fortune, going back to the rocks. We thank you for the wisdom given to the inaugural lecturer, Professor Adewale John, for all that you have taught through him and the capacity to be able to impart a great knowledge of geological and mineral sciences to all of us here. May your name be glorified in Jesus' name. We thank you for all the people that have prayed for this important occasion. We can see the results. Everything went on smoothly from the beginning to the end of the lecture. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. We thank you for the VC, for the management, for the staff and students who have backed him up all through, and for the spirit of appreciation that you are giving to him to be able to appreciate all his teachers, the family where he comes from, the various supporters within and outside the country. We thank you for the love and the fact that you gave him salvation, which is the basis of appreciation, which has made it possible for him to be able to appreciate all these various persons who have contributed to the success of his life. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. We have benefited immensely from this lecture. He has told us that within our very environment of Nigeria and elsewhere, there are various rocks, prominent of which we have sedimentary rocks, within which we have laterite, we have clay and others. And of course, you told us about crystalline rocks, granitic rocks. He has also told us about weathered rocks, even the profiles of which we have a lot of benefits. We have gained a lot. He has also told us about the fact that even within the groundwater of this particular environment, that we have a lot of advantages to derive from them. For all these things he has taught us, bless him in Jesus' name. Strengthen him in Jesus' name. Equip him in Jesus' name. Not only that, he has told us about the challenges facing geologists and other prospectors of mineral elements within the country. These challenges, Father, we hand over to you. Only you can solve these insecurity challenges. Help us to weather the storms that are disturbing the progress of this country. We thank you for everyone here, both great and small. As we live here to our various corners, Father, go with us. Direct our various journeys. Those who are not able to be here, we also thank you for the attention. Bless everyone. Take all the glory to yourself. Because we prayed in Jesus' name.
Thank you very much, Prof, for that wonderful prayer. I'd like to please ask you to remain standing as we take the national anthem. Thank you very much. Let's take the university anthem. Thank you very much. Remain standing as the academic procession leaves the hall in reverse order. In other words, the academic procession will be led by the Vice Chancellor, Professor Ruben Jia Kolo, FFS, followed by the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Alaba Simpson, and followed by the Registrar, Mr. Moses Itomo, followed by the University Bursa, Ms. Olukemi Ojo, followed by the University Librarian, followed by the other deans in the university, the inaugural lecturer, Professor J.E. Adeola, followed by another Professor Adeola, the Dean of the PG School, and Professor Abisoye, the Dean of CBSS, and the Dean of Student Affairs, Dr. Aladebola, and followed by Dr. Amunu, the Dean of the College of Communication and Art Studies. Gentlemen and ladies, once again, we've come to the end of this epoch-making event, and we want to deeply appreciate you on behalf of the university in general, and specifically on behalf of the inauguralists. We thank you for making our time to be here. We pray that the good Lord that brought you here will take you back to your various destinations, hail and hearty, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you. I believe that the night inaugural lecture, you shall be witnesses and partakers in a distant time. Thank you very much. We deeply appreciate you, and thank you once again. Thank you. Signing out. Thank you.